Today, we're gonna test out the cool new Generative Fill feature in the latest Photoshop update for extending image backgrounds, especially when there are people in the shot. In the past, using content-aware scale would mess up the subject, but not anymore. With this new feature, we can smoothly extend the background without messing up the main focus. The Generative Fill feature of Photoshop is based on text-to-image model, which does some serious magic. It looks at the existing content in the image and creates realistic background elements that blend right in. No more tedious cloning or painting required. We can get professional-looking results with just a few clicks. So, without any further delay, let's quickly start the tutorial. Alright, first things first, you'll need to get yourself an Adobe Creative Cloud subscription plan that includes access to Photoshop. Now, if you've already got it installed, you can skip ahead to the next part of the video. But if not, no worries. I'm gonna walk you through the process of downloading it. So, open up the Creative Cloud app and click on the app section. Look for the category that says Beta Apps and click on it. In there, you'll see Photoshop Beta. Just hit the Install, and Photoshop will start downloading and installing on your system. Once you've finished installing Photoshop Beta, go ahead and open it up. Import the image you want to work with. In the image, the man is looking towards the right side of the frame. Now, we want to extend the right side of the image to give our man some more room to gaze into. To do so, select the crop tool from the toolbar. It will activate the crop handles. Drag the right crop handle towards the right. This will expand the image area on that side. You can also try extending any other side of the image if you prefer. Now, grab the rectangular marquee tool and draw a selection around the image. But remember to leave a slight outer edge around the selection. I'll explain why in just a moment. As soon as you create the selection, Photoshop will pop up a prompt box for you. Now, here's a handy trick. When we inverted the selection, few parts of the image stayed inside the selection area. Invert the selection by using the shortcut Shift, Control, and I. When we inverted the selection, few parts of the image stayed inside the selection area. Photoshop will use these areas as a sample to create a seamless and perfect extension of the background. In the prompt box, simply type Add and hit Enter. Photoshop will generate three background options for you to choose from. It's amazing how it beautifully blends the original image with the newly created background. If none of the options suits you, you can simply regenerate more options right from there. Now, let's address an important point. What if you used the selection right up to the image's edges and then ran the prompt? Well, it would create a gap between the original and the extended image. So, always remember to leave that slight edge when making your selection to ensure a seamless integration. And there you have it. You've learned how to extend an image's background. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you never miss an update. If you are interested in learning how to extend background the classic way using content-aware scale, then I have provided the video link in my end screen. It will be helpful for you if you are using older version of Photoshop.